two things. One, I forgot what the first one was. Fuck. It's actually cold in California today. What? Miracle! Okay, some people really do say that it never gets cold in California, but it does get cold sometimes. Okay, we're not completely a sunshine state where like it's hot all the time, 24/7, but it's not like 80 degree weather every single day, even in the winter. Like today, it's cold, it's overcast. At least where I'm at, it's overcast, it's cold. Two things. One, November 24th, 10 a.m. I am going to be on KDHR one last time because it's the end of the semester, so they're going to not have the show anymore. So if you have any questions to ask me, any questions, I'm going to answer any kind of question, go ahead and ask me on my Tumblr or Twitter, but I think it's faster to get to me through Tumblr, so go and I will save your question. Just put like for the radio show or something, I don't know. Just fucking put something on there so that I can know that it's for the actual show so you can hear your question, and it's going to be live streaming online, so I'll link all the stuff down below. I'll actually post the last show that they did that talks about me being on there on the 24th. Second, I went to Angela Johnson's show last night. It was great. It was awesome. I laughed a lot. I love laughing. I hope you love laughing too. I don't know why I'm sitting like that. Yeah, I had two announcements. And I forgot what the other one was. So the Angela Johnson I just added on because I couldn't think of the second one. But anyways, I'm looking like a total bum because I just woke up not too long ago and I have a lot of work to do, but I did want to get this video in. So, okay, let's just go into what I gotta say for y'all. So, I got a question that says, what's your take on couples not having the same priorities for each other? Like, she's my number one priority, but I'm not hers. My take on that is, that fucking sucks because here's the real deal with this, on my perspective. I am the one that will always put her as a number one priority. My girlfriend knows that. I've told her that a million times, and she's told me that she makes me her first priority, which is insanely crazy because she's fucking amazing. It's just amazing that she would say that and she would do that for me because I haven't really ever experienced that I can recall. I mean, if I have, then I would recall. But here's the deal. To me, I've gone through this a lot of times. I've gone through where I've learned my lesson many times, and sometimes it's not good to put them first priority, but there's putting somebody as the first priority, and there's priorities that about putting somebody as first priorities, a sign of that. Did that make sense? I don't think that made sense, but what I'm trying to say is like there's certain things that you don't do or like that you don't just completely block out. Like there's priorities to that priority. Get me? But another point is like I am all about love and I love love and love is what fuels me. So if I have my love, I wanna do so many things. I get motivated to do so many things, and yeah, when things kind of like crash and stuff, like I also crash, but it's like love is what makes me want to move forward in life. Like as silly as that sounds, I am just a fucking hopeless romantic, but I just love it and I just fucking love to be in love. People are different, other things fuel other people, and I'm, you know, I'm done rambling now. So now let's go to my phone to answer the question. Here we go. What's your take? Wait, we already asked that. I already asked the question, didn't I? That's what happens when you turn off the camera and then turn it back on. Okay, first things first. We have to understand that not everybody is going to make you a priority. We got to get that through our brains, which is sometimes in a sense it hurts and it makes us feel bad because we're like, well, hey, are we good enough? Are we not good enough to be your first priority? Like, do you not love me? What the hell's going on with you? If that's something that's of importance to you or you really do want to be somebody's first priority, then that's something that you should look for in a mate when you're going to go look for somebody. I just learned that you can't settle. So if you're settling for somebody who's not going to make you their first priority, then you have been looking in the wrong spot, and that is not the person that you should be dating if being number one priority is like one of your top qualities that you look for in somebody. I know there's some exceptions and stuff, but in the long run, I feel like you're really gonna be unhappy unless you can honestly be okay with it and, you know, compromise and be cool with it, then it may work out. But in my opinion, I think that if that is something that you truly, really want in somebody, you want to be their first priority, like I repeat myself so much. But if that's like one of the things that you really look for, then look for that. If they don't have it, then move it on out and go to the next person, because you will probably not like it in the long run. And it's gonna come back and bite you in the ass. Don't waste your time. Don't waste their time. Don't waste the neighbor's time, unless it's to get some sugar. Do you guys still do that? Does anybody still do that? You still go to the neighbor's house to ask for sugar or lemon and water or something? I don't know why I said lemon and water. I meant to ask for sugar, like eggs. So that's that, right? But couples who don't have each other in priority, like I personally don't know how the fuck they work out, because I feel like that's the same thing with somebody's always doing the extra effort and making, doing more of the work, and the other person is just like, oh, you know, like, I'll get to it when I get to it. It's not always like that, and I could be totally wrong, but from the things that I've seen, because every day there are people who don't make, there are people on the streets and everywhere that don't make it to their first priority, and that's fine. If that works for them, it works for them. I just think at the end of the day, it's what makes you feel fucking good. Like, it's what you like in your life and what makes you happy, genuinely, truly happy, and honestly, truly happy. Not just happy because it's like, oh, I feel happy, I should feel happy. Not because you should, because you are. That's the only thing that matters. Everything else, fuck it. Who cares what other people fucking say, okay? That does not go to say that if they have a genuine opinion, or like an honest opinion, a truthful opinion that you need to pay attention to, that's a difference. Half of the people that tell you shit are always because they're jealous, okay? Half of the time they're just fucking hate. Then other times it's because they honestly have a good opinion and, you know, maybe it's time to listen to them. If it's something that bothers you, bring it up to them, talk to them. If you don't end up liking how things are, if you can't deal with it, then find somebody who will make you their first priority, just like you'll make her or him your first priority. That's that. Or, you know what, even better, break it off, make yourself your first priority, and once you make yourself your first priority and you've worked on yourself and you've done things that you want to do and you're truly happy with yourself, then you go find somebody who will do that for you. And I promise you, there are people out there who will make you their first priority, just like you will make them your first priority. When we refer to first priority, it's like somebody who makes you their everything. And yeah, maybe it has to do with some choices that they make or that they don't make, but in the end, it's all up to them. In the end, if you don't like it, you don't have to be in the relationship. Remember that. You don't have to ever stay in a relationship because you're not happy anymore. You don't ever have to do any of that. If you want to find something else out there, you can. You have the ability to. But be honest with the person that you're with. And I also don't want to be like, oh, go find somebody else, because you could really make things work with this person. If it's meant to be, it's meant to be. But I don't mean just be like, drop that person, like, bye, I'm gonna go find somebody who will make me, I don't know, fried pickles in the morning. I don't know. But in the end, you do have the option whether you want to stay there or not. I mean, you don't always have to settle. That's what I'm trying to say. Actually, I feel like it's better for you to get out of it if you can't fix anything, or they can't fix anything, or whatever it is that's going on, problems, and you can't fix anything. You'll have much more, far more relief being out of it than having to be in it. Although, yes, it sucks in the beginning because it hurts and whatnot, but eventually you'll feel better. And everything is gonna be peachy! Hopefully somebody somewhere got something out of that. Okay, well, this is the end of the video now. And don't forget, KDHR, Monday, November 24th, 10 a.m. The link is down below so you can bookmark it or whatever the hell you wanna do. I'll make sure to post a link on my Instagram so you can tune in. Actually, the funny thing is that I found out that you can listen to it live through my girlfriend. I didn't even know that you could do it, and they figured it out. Like, Jessica and her figured it out, and I was just like, what in the world? I didn't know you were listening to it live, and she was like a live text to me. It was so cute. I thought it was awesome because now you guys can listen to it live wherever the hell you are. What do you call it? I'll give you the link so that you can go listen to it live. Link downstairs. Follow me on Instagram so you can see what time or when. Also, Twitter, I have a lot of updates on Twitter about that. So make sure you do follow me if you want to know more. And I don't know, everybody's on here on YouTube. So all of you guys, if you're not already following me, go follow me so you can see yours truly on the... Well, you won't really see me, but you'll hear me. You'll hear me. I gotta go get to work, so I'll talk to you guys next time. Thank you for coming on here and watching this video. And... have a beautiful rest of your day. Okay. Bye.